Okay, so what is intuitive eating? The easiest way for me to describe what intuitive eating is to just say it's just eating. So when we're born, we are born with a natural instinct to eat, and when we are full, to stop. So if you think of a newborn child, they will latch onto the breast when they're hungry, they will eat until they're full, and then they will latch off. It's just built into us, it's a natural instinct. So the theory of intuitive eating is that we are able to listen to our bodies, listen to our hunger cues, eat when we're hungry, stop when we're full, and our body will tell us what it wants, when it wants it, how much of it needs, and that we would be in tune enough to listen to these hunger cues or these I'm full cues. So it's really, really simple. It's not a complex idea at all. It's essentially taking us back to being young children, eating when hungry, stopping when full. Obviously, society, for lots of reasons, has made this a lot more complicated than it needs to be. In terms of when we are young children, we are given a plate of food, and quite often in most households, I know I do it with my own child, eat what's on your plate, finish what's on your plate, we don't waste in this family. So from a very young age, we are telling our children, don't listen to your cues that are telling you that you are full, because I'm telling you, you need to eat everything that's on your plate. So from a really young age, we are taught to not listen to our bodies at all, we just eat, right? Also, as we get older, the availability of food is so huge. Enjoying food, it becomes a lot more difficult to listen to our bodies and feed our bodies when necessary and stop eating when we're full. So that's kind of a broad overview about what intuitive eating really is. Who is intuitive eating good for? But the first thing to say is, if you are the sort of person that gets up in the morning, fancies eggs, so goes and makes eggs and eats the eggs until they're full and then stops, you probably are already intuitively eating. So well done, good for you. That would be my first sort of step. Am I the sort of person that can take or leave food and is quite comfortable with what I'm eating? So that is the sort of person that already probably is on the way to intuitively eating. Someone who has a good relationship with food, so they're not currently suffering from any sort of eating disorder, any sort of binge eating, anything like that. So that would be something intuitive eating would be really good for you. If you're hormonally regulated, so you're kind of eating well, you're training well, yeah, it's going to be quite an easy transition for you into starting to learn the process of intuitive eating. It's not as simple as just, I'm hungry, I want to eat this, so I'm going to eat it. If you're not currently doing that, then there is definitely a process to kind of get you ready to start intuitively eating, but I will be talking about that a little bit later on in the... So what can you do if intuitive eating is not right for you right now? My best advice would be, the reason why intuitive eating is not right for you right now is probably because you aren't hormonally regulated and you don't have a healthy relationship with food. So my best advice is going to be, go and talk to a professional, right? So before you even start on any journey with intuitive eating, you need to assess the issues that you have with your nutrition currently. So there's tons of charities online. I will link some of them below in the little caption. They're going to give you totally like non-judgmental free advice. If not, speak to your general practitioner and tell them that you are trying to deal with some eating issues because you're hoping to start intuitively eating, and I'm sure they'll be more than happy to help. So all is not lost if you feel like you don't fit into the category where intuitive eating is good for you right now. Keep on trucking, it's a journey. Go and speak to somebody, get yourself healthy and regulated, and then go back to it. Okay, so the last part of this video is tips. If you feel like you are ready to start on an intuitive eating journey, how to get started. The first thing to accept is it is not going to be, oh, hi, I've woken up today and now I'm intuitively eating. It totally doesn't work like that. We need to undo all the damage that society has done that's telling us that eating certain foods is wrong, eating certain foods is right, some foods are healthy, some foods are bad. that we need to finish everything on our plate, otherwise it's wasteful. That there's lots of things that we need to kind of address before we start saying, do you know what, I'm intuitively eating. So tip number one, I personally think it's a really good start to start tracking your food on MyFitnessPal. It's really useful. It gets you fully aware of what you're eating. It kind of shows you some patterns in what you're eating. If at certain times in the day you're craving a certain type of food for lunch or breakfast, it kind of gets you in tune with what your body's asking for. It helps you learn about what's in certain foods. It helps you learn how you feel after eating certain things. If you're very aware of what you're eating, it's a really good starting place. Once you start reliably tracking, you can kind of stop doing it quite as frequently or quite obsessively, and start learning what works for your body, what doesn't work for your body, how many calories you really need to survive. Yes, of course you can work out your BMR, you can work out how many calories a computer tells you that your body needs, but actually the whole point of intuitive eating is that we listen to our bodies. So some days you may eat 3,500 calories, some days you may eat 1,500 calories. Actually, they balance themselves out when you're intuitively eating. Your body will take in what it requires if we really, really listen to the hunger cues and the I'm full cues. So that's my first tip. Start by tracking your food. Okay, the second tip is really quite important for me because I'm very obsessed with being on my phone. And very frequently, I will eat whilst working, while sending emails, while dealing with clients on my phone. So the tip number two is be really, really present when you're eating. So imagine I'm sitting here, I'm eating, I'm scrolling through my phone, I'm looking on Instagram, and I'm mindlessly fork to plate to mouth, fork to plate to mouth. Realistically, if I'm busy looking at my phone, how am I gonna listen to my internal cues? How am I gonna know that I'm full if I'm not present in what I'm eating? I'm too busy looking at booty building tips on Instagram. Meanwhile, muscle memory, fork to mouth to plate is going on. By the time I look at my plate, it's all gone. And I may have been full 5 minutes ago, but I haven't been present in what I'm eating. You need to remove all distractions, TV, phone, my seven-year-old, I'm eating, right? And really focus on what you're doing. That is the first way to be in tune and listen to your body. Tip number three is kind of similar. And it's something that we all need to do, and that is just slow down. So we need to slow down when we're eating. We're not rushing it because we've got to do something else. Eating and food is a priority. It's not something we do in a 5 minute gap because we've got a million other more important things to do. If we're eating nice and quick like this, realistically, our body's not gonna have time to tell us that it's full and that we need to stop and we are going to overeat. So slow down when you're eating. So the next one is really kind of similar, but it's thinking about what you're eating, right? What does it taste like? What does it smell like? What does it feel like when you eat it? It's just another sort of really being present in the experience of eating and making sure that it's not a second thought whilst you're doing something more important. Just make sure you're really thinking about how things taste. This is gonna give your body time to send you cues to say, do you know what? I've just eaten that plate of food, but I'm actually still hungry. Or I'm halfway through this, but I'm actually full. I should stop now and I'll come back to it when I'm hungry later. Okay, so the next one is to always eat when you are hungry. First, determine, am I actually hungry? So I don't drink enough water. So quite often I will mistake thirst for hunger and I will be reaching for a protein bar, whereas actually I probably just need a glass of water. Flipping that on its head, if I'm hungry, don't just go for a glass of water because you've read on Instagram that drinking lots of water will stop you feeling hungry. Our body's asking for food and fuel because it requires it. We should not restrict it, we should feed that. So if you are hungry, eat. If you don't eat when you are hungry, what's gonna happen? Yes, your body's gonna burn fat. Woohoo, we're burning fat. But as well as burning fat, our body's gonna burn muscle. And this is not a good thing, right? This is going to slow down our metabolism primarily, which is going to make burning fat in the long run much, much harder. So yeah, eat when you're hungry, stop when you're full. It really is that simple. I think the last tip really is if you are really seriously interested in learning to do it, then speak to someone who is qualified. start your journey with somebody who is able to talk you through step by step, deal with any issues that you have with food, and kind of teach you the art of intuitive eating. It's really sad that intuitive eating has become a fad or an art, because actually it's just our body doing what it does naturally, which is keeping us alive, keeping us strong and healthy, just keeping us at a nice level where we should be, not stressing because we've overeaten or massively restricting ourselves to the point where we then binge on 5 chocolate bars. If you learn to trust your body, listen to what it's asking for you to do, that is the first step on intuitive eating, and it's the first step to being totally free from the society and every awful Instagram post that is telling you, or YouTube or Facebook or anything that is telling you that you should not eat these foods because they are bad. If your body wants a cupcake, if it really wants it, eat a cupcake. Just don't do it every day. Your body doesn't want a cupcake every day. You want a cupcake every day. So just be sensible, yeah? Listen to your cues. Listen to what your body's trying to tell you. It is there to keep you strong and healthy. So hopefully this has kind of unraveled the mystery behind intuitive eating. It really is totally simple. But where it is simple, it is not as easy as I'm intuitively eating. You really do need to think carefully. You need to work on your issues first. Start your journey and you won't look back.